Toilet's still running. So this video is another Get Unready With Me where I chat about my writing during the day. I hope you don't mind these videos because they're actually really fun to make and they're a really good way for me to sort of reflect back on my writing progress during the day when I didn't have as much time to vlog. So I hope you don't mind. I know these are a little bit more chatty, but feel free to watch these while you also get unready. So enjoy. Hello and welcome to another edition, a very, very short vlog. So just got back from the movie theater, and we saw Murder on the Orient Express, and it was amazing because I love Agatha Christie. I won't say anything more than that, but it was very, very good, and they definitely hinted at a second one, so that would be really, really cool. Yes, I'm using sad little eye makeup rollers to remove my makeup. So I actually managed to get some reading done during lunchtime today at work, which was actually really beneficial. I was able to get a lot done. I read a whole chapter. So I'm definitely going to start doing that every day. I'm so sorry my vlogs are short, Monday through Wednesday. That's when I have long work hours, so I mean, I'm literally just getting, I'm not just getting home, but we went to the movie right after work, and now it's 11 o'clock, so I've had no time. So one thing I haven't talked about yet, and I realized that going through my editing notes when I was refreshing today during lunch, was that I realized one of the main problems my story seems to have is that it's very plot driven, like heavily plot driven, and to the extent where it's like the plot, the characters are being steered. It's not like the characters are making choices that lead to the plot. It's like they're just sort of constantly reacting. And that's, I knew there was something wrong with my story, and I couldn't put my finger on it for the longest time. When I finally realized that, I was like, yes! Like, my characters aren't the ones, you know, having to make a choice really at any given point other than, yes, I'll do the task you ask of me, or no, I won't. It's not like, you know what I mean? It's like they're just constantly reacting. And I think that's a common mistake that a lot of first-time writers make, especially those who outline heavily, because you just have this plot idea and you have these character ideas, and so you kind of mush them instead of like just writing and feeling how you think the character would react and be more organic, I guess. So I definitely have to work on adding certain elements to my story, and I'm actually gonna try not to over analyze it. So I know the general bones of my story as I keep referencing my first draft. But now is really how I want to, when I want to, where I want to fluff it and make it come to life. And so I think that's where I'm going to start pantsing for the first time, which I haven't yet done with the story. But maybe have some scenes that I don't overthink it, and I just sit down and I just write. So each chapter sort of changes character point of view. It always stays in third person except for the prologue and the epilogue, where it jumps to first and second person. Or, I don't think it jumps to second. It's first person, but it breaks the fourth wall, you know what I mean? Like, I address the reader, which I think is cool. I hope you agree. So, with it switching for third person limited each chapter, it's really sort of giving me the opportunity to explore each character's backstory a little bit more. So that's where I'm thinking maybe I can not plot so heavily, or outline what I want to say so heavily. Hydration, so important. Made the mistake in high school, so I don't have the best skin in the world. It's not a secret. And in high school, I thought that was caused purely by excess moisture and excess oil. I didn't know there was good oils and good moisture, and so I would use products that would really dry out my skin, like really, really bad, where it was like, you know, peeling. And now I have lovely scars from that. So don't make that same mistake if you have problems with your skin, especially if you're in high school. Moisturize. Do not be afraid of clean moisturizers. And those are just any that are, you know, no added, no vino, I don't know. Just a little Haley tip for you this evening. So I hope you enjoyed that second segment this month of Get Unready With Me. Basically what happens when I was busy during the day, and so it kind of gives me a chance though to reflect on my writing for the day. Alright guys, that is it for today, and I will see you.